guys, Way from Revolution here with my great friend Mo Coppoletta, legendary tattoo artist, brilliant designer, all around rake and great watch collector as well. And today we're here to talk to you about two Cartier Tonkin-Trez that we have just received, and they're each a pièce unique. So maybe we'll talk a little bit about the Cartier Tonkin-Trez. It's always been one of my favorite references. As you guys probably all know, the tank dates back to 1919. It was a very disruptive kind of formed shape watch, which was incredibly elegant. It rapidly became sort of the choice of all the dandies in the world. But my favorite execution has always been the Tonkin-Trez. What about you, Mo?
Absolutely, yes. When they released it again last year, I was very happy to see it. When we had the opportunity to possibly get a pièce unique, I just jumped on it. Thank to you. And the two renderings they gave us, they were just perfect. So we didn't have to fiddle with them much. So I think these are incredible.
Absolutely. So it kind of goes back to last year. What I really love about what Cartier is doing now is it's really tapping into its archives and bringing these watches back, their icons back, which are their extraordinary sort of history of shape watches, incredibly elegant watches, and kind of refresh for the modern age. But in the case of the Tonkin-Trez, what was so great about it is it actually is as beautiful today as it was when it was born in the 1920s.
Pure Art Deco, but the shape and the size is just it's just perfect. We don't have huge wrists. I don't think we do. No. I think that this shape is just perfect, and as actual now as it was in the 20s.
Yes, 1921, if I'm not mistaken, Mo. I think so. You told me that earlier, so you're absolutely right. And so what was really cool was last year they launched a 100-piece limited edition of the Platinum watch. We both were at SIHH and absolutely fell in love with it. And I didn't realize it, but we both at the same time had approached Cartier and said, can we buy piece number one? Cartier said, let's think, let me check. And then the next day they kind of told us both that, listen, guys, I'm so sorry, but it's already been pre-allocated. And we said, oh, okay. And then I remember Mo and I were wandering around the halls of SIHH, like desolate, sad. You know, I think in French we would
drinking
say,
to forget.
Yeah, we had the douleur, you know, so we were walking around this sort of existential angst. And then I got a message from the guys at Cartier, and they said, well, you know, we have this program where you can enter it and create a custom watch with us. And we said, well, that's a great idea. Why don't we try that? So we asked them if we could. They very kindly accepted us because, you know, we have checkered past, myself in particular. And then they came up with these drawings. We had said, you know, it would be really interesting to incorporate a touch of burgundy or even the salmon dial. And they came up with three executions, essentially.
Yes.
They came up with this watch. They came up with that
this
watch.
One? And the third one?
I think the third one was this, but with like black numerals.
With
to
black
it.
Numerals, no, yeah. Exactly. Salmon with black numerals.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And so we were looking at the images, and I think it was extraordinary.
Remember, we were playing with it in, with a tablet on,
yes.
on the train.
Yes.
In.
Well, we were going to Burgundy. Yes,
yeah,
yes.
Yeah. We exchanged the hands. Yes, we moved yes. the numerals.
So we were in we had won a charity auction for a helicopter tour of Burgundy, and we had thought that since we're in France, we might as well, you know, tap into sort of the French mentality and use this to channel this into giving us inspiration for these watches. So we were, you know, on the train. Mo was looking at the various different images, and being an artist, he was able to also kind of play around with it a little bit. But it soon dawned on us that the
exactly.
executions that Cartier had come up with were far better than anything
we couldn't make it any better.
Exactly. So Mo's in the end has a beautiful silver dial with a soleil sunray finish radiating from the center, and it's got these beautiful burgundy numerals. Mine's got a salmon dial with burgundy numerals and the same sort of soleil finish. Both have the chemin de fer and the traditional signature Cartier sort of exploding Roman numerals, which we adore. And it was interesting was we decided to keep the baton markers, which come from a later period. I think they're more associated with the sort of Cartier London like phase, sort of the more contemporary watches.
Yes.
But we liked it because it was clean, you know.
Yeah, yeah, it's much cleaner. Like
and we both selected to have these sort of black rhodium treated hands on our watches to give us a little.
We tried with the blue, but it wasn't.
We tried.
It wasn't
we tried, we tried with Breguet hands, we tried with blue, we tried with every yeah. single manifestation, but in the end, this was perfect. And it's really nice because it's a watch that is obviously, you know, inspired by the past, but it feels really modern, would you agree?
It feels very, very modern. I think the 1920s and in general, all the Art Deco lines, they're still very much contemporary. If you see every architectural new adventure in London about restaurants, a lot of them anyway, they all get inspired by the 20s, the 20s, because they are... they're timeless, you know, and these lines still play well today. In fact, I'm looking at yours, on your wrist, and they're just perfect. It's not too big, and it's not too small. You find a lot of vintage watches that are very small.
Yes.
This is just perfect.
So. You know, I love this watch because it kind of reminds me of that Halcyon era from, I mean, it was created in 1921, but really from the 50s to the 70s, all the Slim Aarons photographs, all that sort of the original Jet Set era. And it kind of reminds me, I think, that you know, today, you know, money and taste in some instances has diverged, you know, where you have these sort of bottle
the
wars,
opposite ends.
You know, with firecrackers. And when I look at this watch, it's like a refuge into the past. It's a refuge into taste, and it's a refuge into sanity and culture. And that's what makes
Absolutely.
Me happy about it. How about you?
No, Super happy. You I couldn't say better. I mean, it doesn't need much explanation. It's a Cartier tank from that era, and those lines are just
so incredible. We'd both like to thank Cartier for allowing us to enter their custom program. And that's it. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.